ever since we stopped having to chase our food, we have had this problem that our lifestyle is sedentary, we don't get enough exercise, and now we instead have to find the motivation to move from inside. Augmented climbing wall is an experiment in what augmented reality technology can bring to an existing sport, in this case, indoor rock climbing. Knowing your motivation psychology gives you these targets that, okay, let's say we want to design a game that motivates people to move, what motivation components should we try to support? And for example, perceived competence is a good predictor of sport and exercise motivation, so it makes sense to try to make people feel competent. Or we also like to use the term empowered or superhero. One characteristic feature of climbing is that it's very focused on finger strength. And that's sometimes a limiting factor. So people say that I don't want to climb my fingers, I can't stay on the holds. So that's one thing we kind of wanted to change, so that we bring in a diversity of challenges. So for example, there's timing challenges, coordination problems, all kind of more variety, which means that it's more probable that different people can find something that interests them. And it seems to work. So the feedback that we get from climbing centers and also indoor amusement parks is that it attracts new kinds of people to climbing. Designing a good serious game is really hard because the kind of seriousness can easily take away the fun. That's exactly the reason why research in serious games is needed, because companies can't afford to take those risks and explore and find those solutions that work. And then if research goes right, sometimes there's commercial spin-offs, like in our case.